Hello, this is Alol. Welcome to the video lecture series on the course of building construction. This is the lecture number 4 in the unit number 3, that is construction of superstructure, and it is the part 2 in brick masonry. In this video, we are going to see about what are the requirements of good brickwork, what are the types of brick bonds that are available, and what is about brick laying. So these topics we are going to cover in this video. Let's start our lecture by the topic, what are the requirements of good brickwork. So a good brick masonry should utilize or should use the bricks which are sound, hard, well banded and tough with uniform color, shape and size. So it will have uniform color, shape and size, and it should also have tough, and it should be well burnt and very good hardness. The brick should be compact, homogeneous, free from holes, cracks, flaws, air bubbles and stone lumps, and these things the brick should be free from, and soaked in water for at least 2 hours before use. So before you are going to use your bricks, it should be at least 2 hours, it should be soaked in the water. So in the brickwork, bricks should be laid on their bed with the frogs pointing upward. So frog, we know, a small depression in the face, top surface of the brick. So the frog should be pointing upwards, it should not be in downwards. So while we are laying the brick, it should be, the frog should be pointing upwards, not in downwards. The brick course should be laid truly horizontal and should have truly vertical joints. It should have truly horizontal and truly vertical joints. As far as possible, the usage of brick bats should be discouraged. So in any construction using bricks, as far as possible, we have to avoid the usage of brick bats, more usage of brick bats. And as far as possible, the brick wall should be raised uniformly less than 1.5 meter in a day with proper bond. So if you are going to construct a wall around a structure, the wall you are going to construct, so it should be uniformly raised less than 1.5 meter. So for one area, if you are raising 2 meter and another area you are raising 1 meter, it is not good. So uniformly you have to raise less than 1.5 meter. The face should, when the mortar is green, the face joint should be racked to a depth of 12 to 19 mm in order to have a proper key for plastering or pointing. So if you are keeping, the face should be racked, so the depth should be 12 to 19 mm. Why? Because to give a proper plastering or pointing work. So in order to ensure continuous bond between the old and the new, the wall should be stopped with the tooth end. So if you are going to continue a wall between old and the new, we have to end the wall with the tooth end. So it will give you a proper bonding with the new one also. The finished brickwork should be cured for a period of 2 to 3 weeks for lime mortar and 1 to 3 weeks for cement mortar. So if it is a lime mortar, we have to cure for 2 to 3 weeks, and if it is a cement mortar, it should be cured for 1 to 2 weeks. So in order to carry out the brick work at a higher level, single scaffolding is enough. Whereas in the stone masonry, if you are going for a higher level, we need double scaffolding. But in brickwork, meaning single scaffolding is enough. So these are the requirements of good brickwork. The next topic is bond in brick masonry. So brick masonry is consist of brick built to form walls. So brick masonry already we know it consists of brick. So it's used to build to form a wall. So in order to hold the bricks in position and to improve the appearance of the wall, we are using mortar. So mortar is used to hold the bricks in position as well as to improve the appearance of the wall, we are using mortar. So the bricks are held together to act as a single unit by arranging them in a such specific manner so that they rest over each other and break the continuity of the vertical joints. So it will act as a single unit as well as it have to break the continuity of the vertical joint also. So the overlapping arrangement of bricks in order to tie them together in a mass of brickwork is known as bonding. So bonding is defined as the overlapping arrangement of bricks in order to tie them together in a mass of brickwork is a bonding. Next, what are the types of brick bond that are available in the field of construction? So the first we start with the stretcher bond. So in the stretcher bond, all the brick laid as stretchers on every course. So we know what is about stretcher. Stretcher is length parallel to face of wall. So see in the diagram, so everything, the lengthwise is parallel in every course. Here, here, here. So everywhere the length is parallel to the face of the wall. So that is why it is called as a stretcher bond. These stretcher bonds are very useful for one brick partition wall because there are no headers in such wall. So everywhere it will be stretchers only, no headers. So we will use this as a one brick partition wall, and this stretcher bond does not develop proper internal bonding. Does not develop proper internal bonding, and the stretcher bond is used for walls having thickness greater than one brick wall. So the thickness of the one brick wall is 9 inches. So if anything is greater than 9 inches, we will go, the wall thickness is greater than 9 inches, we will go for a stretcher bond. And the second type is header bond. So in this header bond, all the bricks laid as header. So a header means breadth parallel to face of wall. Parallel to face of wall. So in this, every bricks are laid in a breadth wise. See in the diagram, here it is header, 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 header. So everything is laid in the header only. This bond is formed by 3/4 bar at the corner of the face of the wall. So at the corner, here at the corners we will have 3/4 brick bar in each courses to form this header bond. And this header bond does not have strength to transmit pressure in the direction of the length of the wall. So that's why it is not suitable for the load bearing walls. So load bearing walls, we won't use the header walls because it does not have the strength to transmit the pressure in the direction of the length of the wall. Third type of bond is English bond. This type of bonding consists of alternate courses of header and a stretcher. So if you have one header course, you will have structure course. Header course, structure course. So likewise, this is will be in alternate manner. So header, structure, header, structure, header, structure, header, and it will go structure, header. So alternatively, it will move on. In this arrangement, quin closure are used after the first header. So quin closure will be used in first header in each header course. So here it is a quin closure. This is also quin closure. This one is quin closure. So for every header, you will have a quin closure. So why? Because to break the vertical lines. So we are giving quin closure to break the vertical lines. This bonding are generally used in practice nowadays. Nowadays we will use English bond in the construction, and this bond is considered as the strongest bond in the brickwork. So what are the points we have to remember while constructing the English bond? So the header course should never start with a quin closure. So when the in the diagram you see, you will have a header first, then only you will have a quin closure. So in the header course, we don't directly start with the quin closure. So that is the first point. Second point, in structure course, the structure should have a minimum lap of 1/4 of your length over the header. So the diagram, the overlap length should be 1/4. So this is the overlap area for the structure bond. This one is the overlap lap area. So this lap area will be 1/4 of the length over the header. Every alternative header comes centrally over the joints between two structure in the course below. So if you take in the diagram, every header, if you're connecting the header, see here, this header is coming, the joint is coming between center where the two structure will join. So like the every alternative header comes centrally over the joints between the true structure in the courses below. There should not be continuous vertical line. So that's why we are giving the quin closure, to break the vertical line. Alternate course will show either header and structure in elevation. If you're showing them in the elevation, it will show alternative header and structure on it. The number of vertical joint in header course should be approximately twice to the number of vertical joints in the structure courses. So the vertical joints twice in header, it will be is equal to twice the times of structure vertical joints. So these are the points we have to remember while constructing the English bond. The fourth and final type is Flemish bond. So in this Flemish bond, each course consists of alternate header and structure. So see here, this is a one course. This is the one course. In course, we have structure, header, structure, header. So alternatively, we have structure, header, structure, header, structure, header. So alternatively, in each course, we will have header and structure. A closure is used for breaking the continuous vertical line. So a closure like quin closure or quin closure is also used for the breaking the continuous vertical line. It creates better appearance than the English bond. This Flemish bond will create some better appearance than the English bond. So what are the points we have to remember while constructing the Flemish bond is there shouldn't be continuous vertical line. So we have to provide one closure to break the continuous vertical line. And every course will show alternate header and structure in an elevation. So if you are doing the elevation of a brick wall that will show alternate header and structure in elevation. And in every course, after Q1 header, Q1 closure should be placed to develop the face rack. So after the Q1 header, we have to give the Q1 closure should be placed. Why? Because to develop the face lap. So every header is centrally joined over centrally over the joints between two stretches in the course bond. So these are the points we have to remember while constructing the Flemish bond. So these are the four types of brick bond we usually do in the brick masonry. The next heading is brick laying. So how we have to lay the brick. So the first is, brick should be thoroughly soaked in water before laying them in the walls. So why? Because so after laying, it should not absorb water from the mortar, so that we are thoroughly soaking the bricks in water before laying them in the walls. A layer of mortar of depth about 15 mm is spread uniformly. So before you are laying the bricks, we have to lay a mortar of 15 mm over RCC bed or PCC bed, plain cement concrete bed, or brick stone foundation bed. So 15 mm spread uniformly before we are laying it. So after the layer of mortar is done, we have to construct the corner of the wall. So the corner of the wall is constructed first. So for the construction of the wall, one brick is laid first on the mortar and pressed with the hand. So first we have to place one brick on the mortar and we have to press with that with the hand. The level, vertical and the alignment are checked with the help of the plumber. So we have to check the level, vertical, verticality and the alignment with the help of the plumber once where the brick we laid first. And at the another corner, one brick is placed in the same procedure. So here we have to place the first brick and we have to check the level, verticality and the alignment. After that, we have to go to the second corner and again we have to do the same procedure. So once these two bricks are laid, then we have to, a string is tied between these two bricks. So we have to attach a string between these two bricks. So in this diagram, we have a one string. So this string is laid between two corner bricks. So once this string is tied, then we have lay our first course with respect to the alignment. How it is, should we have to assign? It is a structure bond or a header bond or an English bond or Flemish bond. According to that, we have to align our first course. So after the first course aligned, we have to fill the vertical joint with mortar using trowel. See in the diagram. So is fill the vertical joint with mortar. So first we have to align the course, then we have to fill the vertical joints with mortar. So after laying the first course, mortar is spread over the first course up to a depth of 15 mm. So assume this is the first course. So once it is over, once this layer is over, we have to align, spread the our mortar over this up to a depth of 15 mm. And another course similarly laid over it. So we have to another course. Again, once that course is over, we have to lay the mortar at a depth of 15 mm. And we have to similarly, we have to lay the another course over it. So likewise, it will continuously go on. And we have built the wall. Prepense should be kept vertical. And bricks with one frog should be laid with its frog on its top to ensure that they will completely fill. So I think everyone knows about the prepense. So prepense is the vertical joint of mortar which separates the bricks. So it should be kept vertical, and frog is a small depression on the top surface of the brick. So we have to lay the frog on top face to ensure that they will completely fill with the mortar for better bonding. So after completing all loose material and excess remaining part of mortar is removed with brush, as we saw in the diagram. So we have to brush the wall to remove the all the loose material and the excess remaining part of mortar from the wall. So when the height at construction above ground level is 1.5 meter or more, we have to use the scaffolding. So these are the points we have to remember while laying the bricks. So this is the brick laying procedure. So in this video we saw what are the requirement of good brickwork and the types of bond, and what is the procedure for brick laying. So in the upcoming videos we see other topics that are related to the brick masonry. Thank you.